Bhavesh Chandra Sanyal was born in Dibrugarh, Assam. His father, Charu Chandra Sanyal, was a contractor who built roads and bridges in the state. He died when Bhavesh was only 4. Sanyal's mother, Subhashini Devi, was a skilled toy maker and created images of gods and goddesses. She also stimulated in him a love for clay modeling and sculpture. Sanyal received his higher education at Serampore College, Calcutta University, and in 1923 joined the Calcutta Art School, where eminent art critic and historian Percy Brown was the principal. An accident uprooted him from Calcutta, and he found a new destiny in Lahore. He had received an invitation from some congressman in Lahore to make a portrait bust of Lala Lajpat Rai for the 1929 session of the Indian National Congress. On arrival there, he succumbed to the city's charms and decided to settle there. His long and significant stay of 18 years in Lahore, where he took up teaching at the Mayo School of Art, changed his life. In 1936, Sanyal set up his own studio cum teaching workshop called the Lahore School of Fine Arts. In 1944, he married Snehlata, a Punjabi girl whose major interests were theatre and folk culture. Sanyal's studio became the nucleus of a new cultural wave in Punjab and attracted painters, poets, writers, dancers and art critics. Faiz Ahmed Faiz, Sajjad Zaheer and Khwaja Ahmed Abbas were among the frequent visitors there.
Of course, I remembered my family knew Sanyal when I was a very small boy. And he was very closely related with feelings and friendships with the Chatterjee family. And I later on married Renu Chatterjee from the same family. And we were very, very close to Sanyal, you know. So Sanyal, apart from that, he had this wonderful studio above Regal Cinema. And वहाँ काफी जुम्बश होती थी लोग आते थे आता आना जाना काफी यानी usual होता था कोई ऐसी बात नहीं invitation वगैरह नहीं लेकिन कभी कभी एक मौका भी बन जाता था वो मौका एक ऐसा बना कि जब चेतन आनंद ने अपनी पहली फिल्म बनाई जो कि नीचा नगर कहलाती थी and that the first reading of that was done in Sanyal's studio. It was a film and it was discussed and talked about and the first script was read actually in Sanyal's studio and that's a landmark thing, you see. It's a noted film, it's a recorded film now and it's well known. Then, of course, I made my friends there, Prannath Mago and particularly Harkishan Lal and Amarnath Sehgal. They were all there, and they used to come in and out. Aisa koi nahi tha ki wahan register kara ke jao. Wo bhi tha for younger students and so on who wanted to learn. Then the other noted thing is that he painted a picture called Sundari, which was remarkable. And everybody thought that this was influenced by Amrita Shergill. It might have been, I didn't think it particularly did. Because it had very different characteristics in it. I saw the same painting and he sold it to a very senior member of government, I think he was, Mr. Thapar, Ramesh's uncle, I think it was, yeah. Ramesh Thapar's uncle in Bombay. Unke ghar gaya, woh maine woh ye painting wahan unke ghar mein dekhi phir. Ab Bhagwan jaane kaha hai, beautiful painting of a young girl. Dressing, very, very beautiful painting and very well painted picture. So Sanyal had this ability. He was also a sculptor. He made a sculpture of my father's head and of a lot of other people also in the hall. He was a very well-known personality. Unke saath phir wo jab Delhi aaye aur Lalit Kala ke wo secretary bhi the vagaira vagaira. So main un dinon mein maine after that मेरा आना जाना तो खैर काफी था उनके साथ भी तो मैंने जब म्यूरल किया मौर्या का, तो इनको बुलाया देखने के लिए, तो ये मुझे जप्पी लगा के कहते वेल एट लास्ट यू बिकम एन आर्टिस्ट। ये उनके मुझे अभी तक याद है। बड़े बढ़िया आदमी थे वो, he was a wonderful man, you know.
And then came the partition. This epic tragedy turned Sanyal's life upside down, and some of his artist friends and students were equally affected. He arrived in Delhi, leaving behind 18 years of his work and everything else he possessed, including the two palettes and a paint box belonging to Amrita Shergill, which her thoughtful husband had passed on to him. In those days, the Delhi art scene was controlled by the All India Fine Arts and Crafts Society, known as IFACS. Sanyal soon came to feel that such societies used artists merely as tools, whereas Sanyal and his friends wanted that artists should prepare to spread the cult of art and take it to the common people. Ram Babu, owner of Dhumimal and a legendary figure in the Delhi art world of the time, was enthusiastic about changing the art scene in India. Dhumimal was the best art material shop cum gallery in those days. Ram Babu told Bhavesh Sanyal, "I will give you a little space in my shop." So Sanyal and like-minded artists put together some of their works and mounted a show. This also marked the formal inauguration of the Shilpi Chakra Gallery at Dhumimal, and was the genesis of the gallery system in India. Delhi Shilpi Chakra soon laid down a democratic code of functioning. It also initiated the practice of inaugurating its exhibitions in the presence of a guest who would be a distinguished writer, musician, painter, or theatre personality, but never a minister or any other VIP. Artist and critic P.N. Mago writes, "Delhi Shilpi Chakra was born on 25th March 1949 with the assistance of Ram Babu of Messrs. Dhumimal Dharamdas, an art gallery, the first of its kind in India, and was inaugurated on 7th October 1949 in Delhi."
Sanyal sir was very, very respectable person, and in such a down-to-earth person that you could sort of meet him with all comfort. Even if you went to him without any appointment, he'll still entertain you and offer you all sorts of love and affection. And also one beautiful thing about him was that he had no airs about himself. He was probably the senior most artist we had at that time. And but the type of politeness, the type of affection, and the way he treated you, I mean, it always went a long way. And I remember when I went to his house and I was appreciating, I went around the house and wanted to see what I could get from him, what we could buy from him. And he would say, "Dekh lo na, sab to laga hua hai, you know, usko jo tumko acha lagta hai, wo bata dijiye." To us tarah se jo hai wo unme itna simplicity aur itna jo hai apnapan tha ki wo shayad aaj tak kabhi nahi bhulta hai ki, I mean, the type of person he was, and the and also with his work he was very good. I mean, about his work, one doesn't have to say anything, because the perfect, whether it was a landscape or whether it was a figurative painting, I could see that person, you know, has done it from the heart. Unka jo hai wo lagta tha ki wo jaise painting banane mein unko wo sochna ya effort karna nahi padta tha. He'll just sit and do what he felt like doing. And you could see that in his paintings also.
B.C. Sanyal, I feel, is one of the most important personalities as far as modern Indian art is concerned, especially with emphasis to the Delhi art scene, because I feel he was one of the main founders for the first artist group in Delhi, which was the Delhi Shilpi Chakra. and they did not gain as much prominence as the progressives, but I feel their impact on the Delhi art scene and many artists trying to join the Delhi Polytechnic or joining the Delhi art scene, they played a very important role in that. And Sanyal Saab, in fact, in one of his quotes, has also mentioned his close association with Dhumimal by saying that he's thankful to Dhumimal Dharamdas, who in this acute shortage of time in at the time of partition has let out their first floor to for the running of the Delhi Shilpi Chakra. And I think that is in fact a primary reason how even the Dhumimal Gallery came into a professional gallery setup. Also, I have fond memories of him personally because as a kid while growing up in the 80s and the 90s, whenever you would meet Sanyal Saab, even at the age of 90 or 100, he was always erect, his voice was always bold, and it was always a pleasure talking to him. And you know, like, I always looked up to him and said that if anyone is to grow old, one should grow old like him.
First ever in India, we opened this gallery under the auspices of Shilpi Chakra. We were refugees trying to rehabilitate ourselves.
He was very happy. He was very happy because he was very close to Ram Babu, my father-in-law, also to Raviji. And in turn, later with me and Uday. So the closeness that he had and the memories that he had all his career, the way he interacted and when they started the gallery way back in the 30s and 40s. And he sort of had such beautiful recollections with Ram Babu, my father-in-law, and later with Ravi, and then with the next generation, with Uday and me. So, his journey was so long, and the sort of things he used to narrate was always a beautiful experience too.
The Chakra Manifesto declared, "The group recognizes that art as an activity must not be divorced from life, that the art of a nation must express the soul of its people and align itself with the process of progress." Later, the Chakra got its own premises at Shankar Market in Connaught Place. The board of the Delhi Shilpi Chakra can still be seen hanging in Shankar Market, if only to remind passers-by of its rich and vibrant history. In 1952, Sanyal was appointed head of the Fine Arts Department at the Delhi Polytechnic, where he continued till 1960. To quote art historian M.S. Randhawa, this can be called the golden age of the institution. According to Jaya Appasamy, a staffer of the art department, the atmosphere of the department during the Sanyal era was singularly fortunate. No one can claim that he created it alone. It was a result of the joint efforts of the team of teachers and students working in a fluid, easy, unassuming environment against the background of an expanding national economy and cosmopolitan environment. There was not much politics in the air. In the 50s, the art department of the Delhi Polytechnic, now known as the College of Art, had a long list of distinguished colleagues. Sanyal, Dinkar Kaushik, Sailoz Mukherjee, Biren Day, K.S. Kulkarni, Dhanraj Bhagat, Avinash Chandra, and Jaya Appasamy.
So, as an administrator, everybody was afraid of him. If at one time Bowen was the secretary, and being evening student, I was the joint secretary, and Bowen somehow did not contact him for students' annual show, So he went to Allahabad and wrote a note to me, you go and ask. So he flatly refused. He said, you people should have called earlier. Now you haven't, you didn't contact me, so there won't be. So there was no annual show of the students. When Suraj and all these people were in the final year, so they were very sad that we can't over there. I mean, as an administrator, he was par excellence. He would also demonstrate, not in the evening, but I have seen him demonstrating painting in the daytime. He would very clean, all, and also he was, I mean, one can say dandy, everything perfect, beautiful thing. So as in the College of Art, it was the best time. He got people like Somnath Hoare. He also took care of Saloz Mukherjee, because lot of people, even some few students used to say that, you know, he in the evening becomes very rowdy and things like that. So in one picnic, I was sitting with Saloz Saab. He did a landscape, pen and ink, before me, I mean, also showing me. Then after he has done it, he said, go show it to Sanya. I said, sir, no, go. So I went and showed him, and he said, yes, that's what he should be doing.
Well, I joined art school in July 1954. And I graduated, I passed out from art school in 59. He was there, but I think even after quitting art school, he was still there for some time. For some years he was there. But I think he was a very strong principal, very good administrator, and tall, good personality, and he used to walk with long strides, you know. And I haven't seen him taking much of the classes actually, but he was there, and we were in our class, and he would walk anytime in any class actually, while we were working, anybody's class, he would quietly come and pass by and see, and if he feels like, he'll talk to people. And he liked to have all the information about each student, what's going on actually. So that way, he was a very good administrator.
Another thing, as administrator and artist, he was the soul behind Silpi Chakra. And when we became attached to Silpi Chakra, it is something like about 62. He had, sometimes Naina Devi comes, sings ghazals, and some other musicians are coming. Even at one time Ram Kikkar came and also sang usual things. And he would arrange some kind of a dinner so that people, so all these things. And the exhibitions in those days of Silpi Chakra were quite something.
After he had retired completely, you know, he used to come out to the exhibitions opening, and then that time he was perhaps unwell. And then he sent me a note by post actually into the gallery saying, Gopi, I'm not been able to make it today, but I wish you best. I would like to pay for your catalogue, and please, if you can have it delivered. I'll show you that letter, you know, which is like
trophy for me, you know, because very important, because his presence to my show was, it meant something. He guided me so much, you know, not individually, but he'll come to the class, he'll stand by behind you, see the work, and he'll ask questions, you know. One word was not free in speech when he was conversing, you know, there was a personality for such, you know, that I personally, you know, was scared, you know, because not many, there are students I remember were very friendly with him, actually, would make jokes with him, actually, like Suraj, Amal, very senior student. And like Kiran, they will laugh with him, they will enjoy talking to him, they will make jokes with him. He used to play flute.
The address, 26 Gold Market Studio, later called Gallery 26, had an abiding association with Bhavesh Sanyal's personal life, for it was this room which had helped him to rehabilitate himself after the fateful, blood-soaked partition of India. M.S. Randhawa, then Deputy Commissioner of Delhi, had recommended the allotment of this room to the New Delhi Municipal Corporation in 1947. In those days, it was a prominent meeting place of painters and other intellectuals of the city. Sanyal writes in his reminiscences, "The squalor of a marketplace, the stench from the neighboring fish and poultry shops, the non-stop tick-tick orchestration of a typewriter training school, the din of ever-flowing traffic below, all added up to a milieu and atmosphere which I felt was congenial to a destitute refugee artist." Artist Ram Kumar painted here for a couple of years from 1964. Hussein, Krishan Khanna and Tayyab Mehta would also visit the studio often. Alas, now this historic place is defunct and Gold Market is also getting transformed unrecognizably. In 1960, Sanyal was appointed Secretary of the National Academy of Art, or the Lalit Kala Academy, and held that position until 1969. Architect Habib Rahman had designed Rabindra Bhavan for the three academies in the vicinity of Mandi House in Delhi. In November 1961, Sanyal had the honour to be the first to occupy the Lalit Kala wing with its large galleries. Of all the academies, Lalit Kala was the most difficult to run and always challenging. But he managed it successfully. In 1980, he was elected Fellow of the Lalit Kala Academy, and in 1984 was awarded the Padma Bhushan by then President Gyani Zel Singh.
Was a very generous person and an artist with multimedia works. He created paintings, sculptures, drawings. And I really feel blessed that when I curated a show titled Drawing 94 for Gallery Espace, he gave me two drawings. But that is not all. When I had gone to select the drawings to his house in Nizamuddin, he showed me many drawings of cats. I was really wonderstruck seeing so many drawings of cats only. They were in large number, and he told me that you can select from these any much as you like. So I really don't remember how many I had selected and how many were displayed, but about two I am quite sure. And one was published in the catalogue also, this much also I remember. He always supported us, the younger ones, very caring, very loving person. And again, I would repeat that I really feel blessed that when I came to Delhi in the 60s, in the early 60s, he was there, not only he, but Al-Qaji Sahib was there, Ravi Shankar was there, Hussain Sahib was there, and Yamini Krishnamurti's dance was a craze. So that was the Delhi of that time. And since then, as we all know, for years together, for many decades, all these stalwarts and their presence in Delhi meant a lot to all of us, to the cultural world, to the art world. I can remember on many occasions that Sanyal sir was there. And during the Drawing 94 show also, we had every day seminar, talk, poetry reading, and I still remember that it was perhaps the last day when the poetry reading was there, was held. And Sanyal Sahib, for some reason, was a bit late. The house was packed. Both the galleries of IFAX, where the show was held. And people, when they saw that Sanyal Sahib was there, immediately a chair was brought for him. And he sat through the evening listening to the poems in Hindi, in English, by artists and by poets. About Sanyal Sahib, what strikes to me especially is this, that he was a Bengali by birth. But he spent most of his life in North, in Punjab, in Delhi. So he was seeped in two cultures. And now I can feel and remember that why drawings by cats. Because I had seen in Calcutta and elsewhere also that in Bengali household, the presence of cats means a lot, even today. Because that is why we find in Bengali literature, especially in poems and in novels, in short stories, in paintings also, in sculptures, in paintings. One can remember Jamini Roy's paintings of cats. So I really would like to conclude that knowing him, seeing him, his presence, it all inspired us and inspires even today.
According to Sanyal's daughter, Amba Sanyal, a gifted theatre artist and costume designer, he was not only a good administrator, but a good institution builder as well, whether it was the College of Art, Shilpi Chakra, or the Lalit Kala Academy. That was because he brought people together. He had a knack for it and the spirit to do so, to follow a certain vision, share it, and fend off the elements antithetical to it. Amba says he didn't labor as an artist. Each of his strokes was like an integrated motion on the canvas. He would never try and correct a stroke. He was ironic, but not dark. Even after the partition, he did not become dark. He had a deep love for the world and the capacity to share this love.
You know, let us take another example of this painting. As an artist, when I saw this work or when I see this work right now also, again the term personality comes, that the tall height of the artist reflects here. And the mother and child is a subject, if you all agree, has been most favorite or most common, say anything you like, through the history. Let that be Madonna of the Rocks, let that be take any example, till Jamini Roy, till Bhavesh Anhal, till Dhiraj Chaudhary. I remember Dhiraj Chaudhary's that cuddling drawing, very fantastic it was. So, you know, this subject has been a very important factor because probably the weave of the society. The weave of the society did talk about this subject as one of the most important. But when I see this work, yes, this red line do talk about a very interesting thing, the flow. Do talk about even the status of the woman. All these are various other angles. But the most interesting thing which struck me is somewhere the brown against this white. The brown against this white. The feeling, let's say, I don't know whether it is the right perspective to say or not. Bhavesh was a very charming, tall, handsome, and fair person. But when he is painting Indian, the brown color, it's natural to reflect here. That is what struck me and hold me. And I see this, that the personality gives a sublime character. But the son and the complexion of the mother and the other things do talk about the Indian and the Indian. Let that be the contrast of the economy, financials, this thing or anything. A simplicity is also there. This line, this red line is the lovely thing what I feel as an artist when I see this work like this.
First of all, I was to say that we will never say that he is Bhavesh Sanyal. We used to say always, Sir Vishy Sanyal. And he has a tremendous contribution in the field of art. And when I came to Delhi in the year 1969, I joined as a lecturer, College of Art, and that time he was, he retired from that secretaryship from Lalit Kala Academy. He used to visit College of Art off and on. And fortunately, the day I joined, and he came to the college and he asked me to sue me, and you were from the Calcutta? I said, yes, sir. Don't you feel cold? Because it was in the January. Don't you feel cold? I said, no, sir, I love cold and like cold. And he felt so excited. Oh, it's beautiful. No Bengali boy says that you're always chilled, sir, I'm not like that. That was the introduction only. After that, long, long, long years with his relationship, and I am really grateful in various ways. And he used to guide me. He became a jury of my selection when I got a British Council scholarship. Our family and Professor Sanyal's families are almost the one, because we used to, often on, we used to visit his Nizamuddin's residence. And he loves his Bengali food, and my wife used to cook for him like that. Anyway, as a painter and sculptor, I can differentiate that is he a sculptor, is he a painter, because he exercised every media, especially initially he was very much interested in the portrait making, and he has done a lots of the good portrait. In his young days, I had the chance to help him, assist him when he was preparing the portrait of life sitting portrait of Mahatma Gandhi, and that was in the College of Art, and I was to help him because he was too old at that time for his finger was a little bit of shaky, and he used to call me. Do a little bit of help. So that was my golden experience with him.
I stand in front of portrait of Maharaja Ranjit Singh Ji, painted by Bhavesda. But I still stick to my own point, that is personality. You know, these older generation artists, let that be anyone from any field, not that only painter, let that be theater artist, filmmaker or anyone, Let that be even like the stance of El Greco's elongated figure, or Hussein Saab's drawing, or Suzaji's drawing, or Bhavesh Das. The personality reflects. This is, in a way, Maharaja Ranjit Singh Ji, and also, in a way, for me at least, I see Bhavesh Das in this. Let that be this, see this part, the mustache, the expression of the eyes and the nose, and the gait of the stance do talk about the personality whom I knew, know as Bhavesh Das. Apart from the shod and the other structure, it is Bhavesh Das. Otherwise, it is Maharaja Ranjit Singh Ji as painting done by Bhavesh Das.
Andretta is just 13 kilometers from the tea gardens of Kangra Valley's Palampur district in Himachal Pradesh, a peaceful village and artist's colony. Over time, it became a meeting point for some of the most prominent names in the spheres of art, theatre, pottery, etc. in the last century. Sanyal had a deep-rooted love for the Punjab Himalayas and its colourful people. He knew Mrs. Nora Richards, a writer who led the life of a recluse in Andretta. P. N. Mago wrote that Sanyal visited Andretta regularly after his first visit to the valley from Lahore in the 40s. The poetry of his landscapes seems to empathize with the elements, with his subject, and the gentle moods of nature. They reveal his feelings of intoxication in the midst of nature, and the spiritual peace he derives from it.
To me, Sanyal Sahab is a very big personality in art field. And I had a chance to talk to him and to see him, to be with him for, I think, 4 or 5 times at least, long sittings. Not like hello, no. 75th birth anniversary. Then Anandev as a chairman when he was, and K.S. Kulkarni made his portrait like a king. Then I met long sitting with Dheera Chaudhary's housewarming party. And after seeing him sitting with the on the long chair, he's sitting and we are sitting in front of him. And I just said, sir, you are my grand teacher. What is grand teacher? Grandfather, I know what is grandfather, grandmother. But what is grand teacher? My sir, you are my grand teacher. Why? Jagmohan Chopra ji and Rajesh Mehra ji are my teacher. So you are their teacher. So you have become my grand teacher. And he laughed so big. Everybody was enjoying what he said. So then there are few places where I met him, and he came to college. Suraj Ghai gave me a call from Gadi. This Nankatyal and Prem Singh are getting studio from Lalit Kala Academy, and they have requested to open the studio by the hand of B.C. Sanyal. And you are doing photography nowadays. He saw me doing photography. You come and take the photograph. I took the camera. I had one transparency, two camera. One with the transparency, one was with the negative color. And I did that both 72 shots in 15 minutes.
In the words of art critic Shanto Datta, it was Sanyal's instinctive sense of humor and his rare capacity to laugh at himself in the most bizarre circumstances that saw him sane and sound through the vicissitudes of fortune. Poet and art critic Keshav Malik said, "The meaning of being Bhavesh Sanyal is that it signifies true patriotism. It means we must clean the springs of creativity of their current pollution and art of its warts and pimples. Artists like Sanyal can help clean the body politic." Sanyal was active with a renewed creative urge even in his late 90s. He once said, "I have, at long last, at the age of 95, learnt to hold the brush. I can now use it like a sword." B.C. Sanyal was lucky to be able to attend his 100th birth anniversary celebrations, organized by IFAX in 2002. The end came peacefully on 9th August 2003, when a soul full of great creativity and achievements met its maker.